Hello friends, it's me, Kim here, of Space Dragon and Kim. And you might be wondering, where is Space Dragon? Where is he? Well, I actually know. He is interviewing a Canadian Space Agency astronaut right this second! Take it away, boys!
Yeah!
Thank you, Kim, and thank you, Jeremy Hansen, for joining us here today.
Yeah, my pleasure. Great to be with you, Space Dragon.
As an astronaut, you're an expert on outer space, so I gotta know something. Are aliens real?
I don't really know. I've never seen one. I don't know anyone who's interacted with aliens, but the universe is so enormous. Like, you can't even understand how big our universe is. And everywhere we look, we see stars, and every star we look around, we see planets. And there's just so many, it's hard to believe there wouldn't be other alien species out there.
The universe sounds enormous. If you could go anywhere in the universe, where would you want to go?
Well, I mean, I've always dreamed of walking on the moon. I don't know what it is about the moon, but you can go outside, you can do this. You can go outside your house and you can look up and you can see the moon from Earth and you can imagine walking on it. And I've always wanted to do that. And I often thought, wouldn't it be cool to stand on the moon and look back at the Earth in the sky instead?
Speaking of spacewalks, what would happen if you were out on a spacewalk and you took your helmet off?
Oh my gosh. Horrible idea, Space Dragon. Yeah, if you're ever on a spacewalk, you do not take your helmet off, no matter what. Because if you took your helmet off, you would die. All the air would be sucked out of your suit, and your body needs that air, and not only the air, but the air pressure. So imagine the space suit is kind of like a balloon, and it keeps that air pressure in, and if you get a hole in it, it goes psst, and the air comes out, and your body cannot survive without that air pressure.
Would my head pop like a firecracker?
No, I don't think your head would pop, but your blood vessels might burst. Sometimes we say your blood would boil. It's not that your blood would get hot, but it's just one of those things. When the air pressure goes away, your blood will start to turn into gas instead of liquid.
That is terrifying. What about a black hole? Would you ever want to visit one of those?
Oh boy, no, Space Dragon. Also a bad idea. We don't think if you went to a black hole that you would ever come out. We don't think you'd survive. So it's really cool to learn about them, but not a cool place to visit.
I heard that if you go to a black hole, you get squished down to the size of a pea. Is that true?
Yeah, probably smaller than that. Yeah, super, super crazy amount of gravity in a black hole and it would just squish you up.
Okay, I've got a bit of a gross one here for you. When astronauts go to the bathroom, where does the stuff go? Do they just flush it into outer space?
No, I mean, great question. So an important question, because no matter wherever humans have to go, we're going to have to go to the washroom. And so we do two things. We separate the urine and we separate the feces. So the poop, we keep them separate. And we collect the urine and we actually recycle the urine. So we use the same water over and over again. It's super clean, sounds disgusting, but we actually keep using the same water over and over again. And then for the feces or for the poop, we send it back in a cargo vessel and it ends up burning up on its way back to Earth.
That's kind of hilarious. So like, kids, next time you wish on a shooting star, it may be something a little less magical than you think.
It's so true.
All right, now, I heard a rumor that you once lived at the bottom of the ocean. Is that true?
That's true, yeah. So we have a habitat, which is really kind of like a mini space station on the ocean floor, because when we're underwater, we can float and it sort of feels like you're on another planet with less gravity.
I heard that you're an airplane pilot as well.
Yeah, I love to fly airplanes.
So I guess you're an expert on flight. I gotta ask you something. Could I tie a bunch of helium balloons to a chair and then fly to outer space on my own?
No, you wouldn't make it. Because what would happen, Space Dragon, is it would be really dangerous for one thing, but if you tied a whole bunch of balloons to your chair, you would start to fly. Eventually, you would get high enough that the balloons would pop, and then you would fall all the way to Earth.
Well, thank you, Jeremy, for taking the time to chat with us today.
Ah, you're a great space pal, Space Dragon. It's an honor to chat with you. Thanks for hanging out.
Thanks, I could chat to you all day, but I should probably give you some space. I bet you've heard that one like a million times.
Maybe once or twice.